Look at this. I've got it for 70 bucks and I built a Hackintosh of it. Do you think it's an old crap? Maybe, but what about I will tell you it can edit and render 4K videos without any problem. Impossible? Let's see. It has Intel Core i3-4330 on H81M D3H motherboard and only integrated iGPU Intel HD4600. No dedicated GPU. So, question of the day. Can it handle 4K videos, edit and render it in Final Cut Pro 10 for just 70 bucks? I've already done also some synthetic benchmarks of this build and prepared for you already tweaked Clever folder to download. So if you want such a machine, you can simply download my whole configuration and you can run it straight away without any tweaking or knowledge how to build a Hackintosh, and link to it is now in video description. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell next to it so you don't miss any of my Hackintosh tutorials. But let's go back to our 4K video test. Here we are in the latest Apple Final Cut Pro 10. Now let's have a look to about this Mac. 3.5 Intel Core i3, 8GB of RAM, Intel HD4600. System report says this it's the only GPU in the system. For all my tests, I have background render disabled. Also, as you can see here, I have only original media and no optimized or proxies. My viewer is set to better quality, so no optimizations for old and slow hardware. But look at that! Scrubbing in timeline is incredibly responsive, no lag. And as you can see here, it's really 4K timeline, 30fps. And all my source media are the same, 4K, 30fps. Unbelievable, isn't it? I have some basic color correction applied to all of my clips. But how about the render time? I will set to 4K resolution and H.264. You can also check time on clock in top right corner. And I have screen recording on while shooting, so it also eats some resources. Render time was 9 minutes and 47 seconds for about 4 minute long clip in 4K, 30fps. But will it help with render times when I plug in dedicated GPU, some cheap? What about AMD RX 560? I've done that already and tested for you. Watch it. Again, for you to believe me, as you can see here, it's really RX 560. Yes, RX 560. Scrubbing in timeline is absolutely the same. Again, better quality, 4K timeline, everything the same. Let's check the render time now. So render time with dedicated RX 560 was 3 minutes and 14 seconds, which is 3 times faster than with just the iGPU Intel HD4600.
But will it help even more when I plug in some more powerful GPU like AMD RX 580 with 8GB of VRAM? Let's find out.
Confirmation, it's really RX 580 with 8GB of VRAM. So, what about the render time now?
Will it be even better? What do you think? Render time with RX 580 was exactly the same as with RX 560, so no further improvement. So you don't need to spend extra money for it.
So, what is the conclusion of this video? As you could see in the CPU and GPU usage graph, nor CPU nor GPU was any bottleneck. Even with just a crappy PC like you would say in the beginning when you saw it for the first time, you can comfortably edit and render 4K videos without any problems in Final Cut Pro 10. So even for only 70 bucks, you can build your own Hackintosh which is able to even handle those type of workloads. As you saw, adding dedicated RX 560 for about 100 bucks into the system helped a lot. Render times was cut down 3 times, but it's really not necessary when you are low on a budget. And adding more powerful AMD RX 580 did not help in any way, so you don't need to spend extra money for it. I hope I brought a little bit of light into your mind. Don't worry, heads up, even poor students with no money can build great Hackintosh and can start their career as a star of YouTube, Facebook, Instagram or just of family movies. If you want to learn more about how to build a Hackintosh, subscribe to my channel and watch also my other videos and Hackintosh tutorials. I hope you found this video useful. If so, please click on the like button below. Thank you for watching and see you next time.